Okay, so now we'll talk about a concept called model view controller. But what we're really talking about is a pattern. There are many ways that you can structure your PHP applications. And sometimes you use a framework like Symfony or Laravel, and they prescribe a very precise structure for your PHP code. Or you just go wild and just write PHP code however it comes to your mind. And so this is that little guessing game. And you know, it's just starts with HTML. This is just some, this is PHP, like the old Wild West and Woolly PHP. You know, the first line is title, does some stuff, and then it drops into PHP and does some printing, and then it ends with a paragraph, and then it's done. And so, you know, you're sort of dropping in and out HTML and in and out HTML, you're doing some computation, you're doing some whatever. You just kind of put it together the way you want. And if you are doing mostly static work, like just HTML mostly with a few little things that you were sticking in, it's okay, because PHP is like a templating language with little tiny bits of code in the middle of it. That's not all bad, right? But as your application gets more complicated, you end up doing quite a bit of work handling this incoming data. It's not just a guessing game. If everything was as simple as a guessing game, this would be a fine coding style. And so that's where this notion of model view controller and the discipline of thinking carefully about where you do what inside your PHP scripts. And like I said, you might be using a framework. Oops. You might be using a framework to do some of this, which will give you some really clear structure about when you can do computation, when you're supposed to talk to the database, and when you're actually generating the output. So, I have a pattern that I use, and it is a highly simplified version of Model View Controller. And you may or may not like my pattern. I'm going to use it for the rest of this class. But at some point, you will run into some other pattern. But for now, it's a really nice way to do a simple Model View Controller without doing it in a bunch of files. One of the things I don't like about the other approaches is they tend to put little pieces of the Model View Controller in many different files. And I think for beginning programmers, that makes it a little complex. But so this is how I do it. This is how I organize it. And I write a lot of code this way because I like simplicity and ease of understanding and ease of use. But I also like discipline at the same time. But if you choose to use a framework like Laravel or Symfony or Cake or whatever, no problem. It's fine with me. And all the skills that you're learning here apply equally. It's just where you put the code is a little different in those frameworks. So I think I made it clear. These are just, they're not rules. They're the rules I'll follow, but they're suggestions. And the way it basically works is if you're writing a script that's going to handle incoming post data, you have the page output, and the page output is the template is at the bottom. So this is like a template. And at the top, you handle the incoming data. So you handle the incoming data at the top, and then you print the output at the bottom. And the key is that you produce no output here at the top. You know, you handle the data, you produce no output. You start as the first line of the file as ?PHP, because you do your coding at the top, and then you do your templating at the bottom. And so you tend to have as little code down in the bottom as you can, and you really just have markup and you put variables in. Sometimes you sneak a for loop in or something like that, but you tend to put the bulk of the code that's handling any incoming data above where you even start the first line of code. And this is a pattern of the model view controller. And so the idea of the model view controller is that you separate out the different aspects of the request response cycle from the time that the user clicks their button, right? So, you know, the user clicks a button and the controller is in charge of all this. The controller is like the orchestrator. The model is the data storage. So the controller sends all the data back to the database. And then there is a new user interface. The view is the what you see, and that goes back to the user. So it's sort of controller model view, controller model view, controller model view. The controller is like the orchestrator of this. The view is the output. The model handles the data, and the controller routes it. And you'll see what will happen is the controller will also sometimes say, we've handled everything in this script. We're going to send you to another script. And that's what routing is the movement from one script or one page to the other is also part of controller. So it's orchestration and routing. And this will all make more sense as our examples get more complex. This is just getting started so that you'll begin to understand some of the terminology that I can use when I'm showing you some of them more complex. And so the way it works is the top part is the silent part that handles the incoming data, and the bottom part is the part that produces the output. Now, some of the output comes from the processing, and so there is a bit of data that is passed between the model and the controller. And the way I think of it is I always like to be able to draw sort of a line. And below this line is when I start output, and above this line is when I do the majority of my processing. But I have to pass some information from above the line bit to the bottom bit. And so in this case, I'm building a guessing game, and it's going to pass this variable old guess and message down across this line, and then I will pull that data out in here. Okay? And so the thing that is passed, there's a chunk of data that is created at the point of view of devolving processing, and that's passed through, and we call that, call that the context. Okay? And you'll hear this in other frameworks. They talk about the context that the controller passes to the view, et cetera, et cetera, et cetera. And so this top part is the model, handles the incoming data, prepares the context, and the view is renders the output using the context as its input. And so another of the simple rules is above this mysterious magical line, you're not supposed to produce any HTML, right? No HTML. And below the line, you can have little bits of code, like I've got this if statement, that's not a terrible thing, but certainly no database activity. So all the database happens up here, all the SQL happens up there, and then it's just sort of simple rendering with, you know, maybe a loop or an if, but not something that actually talks to the database. And that's how I implement Model View Controller. So if we look at the top part of this, the model part of this, remember that the goal of the model is to do no output, but pass down a context. And so the thing that this guessing game is going to need is what the previous guess was, so it can put it back in the little form field, and a message as to whether or not the post data was high, low, or bad, right? And so one thing you'll see in all my model view controllers is there's sort of a big if statement, and I'm saying, is there any post data? And part of that is because the first time this script runs, it's a get request, and so it just produces the output. So in effect, on a get request does this and skips everything else. And then once you submit the data with the post request, then it comes back in and the data is here, and then this is for the post request. So this is the get request. The get request sort of skips this and the post request does it. Actually, the get request does these two lines. And so the get request says the old guess is blank and the message is false. And so that's the context. If it's a get request, the context is simply old guess and message. Now, if there is some post data, we're going to just add zero. I'm not going to do I didn't put a bunch of validation in here. I'm just adding zero to it to turn it into a number, although I kind of don't need even to do that. If old guess is 42, it's great. The message is great job. In the previous example, I was putting echo statements in here. So now, in this model view controller, you're not allowed to use echo statements. So we have to pass the message down. And so the message is either going to be great job, too low, or too high. And that's going to be passed down into the template. So these two variables, whether it's a get request or a post request, these two variables, old guess and message, are the context that's being passed between the model and the view. And now if we take a look now at the view, and so the view is really the start of the HTML, so it has the HTML tag, we could put a doc type in there as well, the head, blah, 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 body, blah, 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 blah. And then, you know, we might put a little bit of logic here to just put this paragraph out, checking to see if that message was false or not, because if there was no message, we don't want to print it out. And so this is okay in the view part. It's really just checking something and conditionally issuing output. That's no big deal. And then we also have in here the printout of the old in between the values, right? I think there might need to be a double quote there. I should fix that. And so that's the thing. And so you can see the context comes in here and the context comes in there. And so this from here to here is really almost all HTML with a few little dynamic bits that are set from the context. Okay, and so that's the code there. This is the top part, passes down the old guess and message. when you pass it, and you see that it will show you the old value when it's done. So we've talked about GET requests and POST requests. We've talked about HTML entities, data validation. We talked about the various form fields, the new fields in HTML5. And we talked a little bit about Model View Controller. Model View Controller will make sense as we do increasingly sophisticated amounts of work in that top part, that is the silent kind of processing for each of the scripts that we do.